Now, this is chronic kidney disease, and the reason you want to recognize acute kidney injury is because we want to catch it, we want to intervene, just like nurses did for me. They caught that, they notified the healthcare provider, we got IV fluids going, and I resolved just fine. I don't have chronic kidney disease, but if that had progressed to chronic kidney disease, this is what my life would have been like. It happens over a period of time for a lot of people. We're going to talk about the types of people that are extremely at risk for this, but remember that it happens gradually over a period of time. Now, we come up with definitions of everything. Remember, we defined acute kidney injury as an increase in serum creatinine and a decrease in urine. Now we're going to talk about the stages of chronic kidney disease, and the measurement we're going to use for that are glomerular filtration rate. Now it will be the estimated glomerular filtration rate. You know, we get that from the creatinine because it's just too complicated to get the actual one. So take a look at that kidney. Now you see this is an introduction back to the one we talked about at the beginning of this video series. See how gnarly and knobby and shriveled that is? That's a kidney that is struggling just to get anything through it, right? So it's not able to function. So I want to talk to you about 8 causes of chronic kidney disease. I'm going to start with just 2, though, because these 2 are the most common causes of chronic kidney disease. And they're actually the 2 that we can make the biggest difference in if we can educate our patients in a positive and supportive way. Because the better control we have of these 2 diseases, the better chance we have of preserving kidney function. So the main 2 causes are diabetes and high blood pressure. Okay, diabetes causes microvascular changes, and that's why the kidneys can really suffer. High blood pressure is just pounding those nephrons and those glomerulus, and that damages the kidney. So what we're looking for here is, in diabetic patients, write yourself a note, tight glucose control. That means the lower we can keep a patient's blood sugar over a consistent period of time, we can minimize the risk of kidney disease, chronic kidney disease. High blood pressure, we can help them with lifestyle changes and medications so that you can help control that blood pressure and minimize the risk of chronic kidney disease. Okay, before we go on and do the other 6, make sure that you've got laid down in your mind that diabetes and high blood pressure are the top 2 most common causes of chronic kidney disease. Now, if you haven't been in the hospital yet, this may not make sense to you, but if you've spent a day in clinicals, you already know how many of the patients did you see that had either diabetes or high blood pressure or both. Right. The majority of patients that we end up taking care of in the hospital have both of these. So we can always help these patients become healthier and avoid that chronic kidney damage. When that chronic kidney disease gets an advanced stage, you end up with really life-threatening and dangerous levels of waste and fluid and electrolytes building up in the body. So this is what you want to have in the back of your mind when you're having those difficult conversations with your patients, to encourage them to make the tough choices sometimes to follow a strict diabetic food plan, right? It's not as fun to follow a diabetic food plan around the holidays or when everyone else is celebrating. So we need to help them find ways to incorporate exercise in their life and a healthy diet. And that applies to both diabetes and high blood pressure.